Hello Dudes and Dudeens, Domination Tips, reporting back for duty. Two topics are awaiting us today. The main or the first topic will be our trade goods. And the second topic I want to talk with you about is the new event, the Korean event, I think. Birthday event or something like that. And the effects which are still there and which are lasting for about 3 days, I think, up to Monday. So let us start with a multiplayer attack. You see all of my raiders are trained. And we'll try to get some nice resources by dropping my medals, my medal count. No. I'm looking for about 200,000 would be really nice. 200,000 and more. No. I upgraded 4 or 5 parts of my walls already, because farming during the current event, which I will explain later to you, is really easy because of the decreased training times. Oh, come on, show me an enemy which is worse to attack. This one is not the best, but it's pretty nice. The roads are quite outside, so I don't need many raiders to get at least all of his gold. I'm not quite sure. Are here any trade goods to get? No, no trade goods, only food, and I don't need the food. So, retreat. That I meant. So, short retrain, only lost 5 raiders, and again going for the next multiplayer. This one seems to be really nice, but I have to look it up. I'm not quite sure. The storage buildings all look really, really full. Yes, it looks like all of the his resources are in the storage building. Yes, nice. And also some oil, which is placed really nice outside, so that I can take it. Now there's also some gold, not very much, but there's some gold in the in the crates, whatever, in these bunches of gold from the caravans, I think. 5 up to 6,000 into every bunch. But let's go for the last market. Yeah, it's really nice loot. Okay, bye-bye. Wow, great. That was a really great attack. I think we can do another one, and then we will start with our topic with the trade goods. The attacks are that much efficient that I can do very, very many of them without losing very many troops. Nice, really nice. Oh, not really nice. The storage buildings looked quite full, but they are not full. Like you see, I only got half of the complete amount of gold. There is much gold inside these gold humps, whatever. I don't like it if it is split up that much. I will also take some oil. Okay, that's enough, I think, enough. Then we can let our troops retrain and deal with the first topic of today. Okay. So the first topic we want to deal about today, like I told you, are our trade goods. And there are eight of the national trade goods, which are quite eight because there are eight nations currently in the game. We don't want to talk about them because they are not this much special because they are not able to getting stolen by someone who attacks you. We want to talk about the five main and old trade goods like cider, diamonds, metal, leather, and what's the last one? Fur. I think it's fur. And like probably all of you know, but I want to tell it nevertheless so that everybody knows, all of these trade goods, with exception for diamonds, can be produced on your own map. So you can just use the animals which are running around, or the gold mine and the trees to produce four of these five trade goods which are available. Only with exception of the diamonds. The diamonds can only be being produced or being earned by stealing it from the storage house or destroying town centers from other players, or at least 3 up to 5 stars them. If you 3-star an enemy, you will have a specific chance of getting a diamond. 4-star is getting is a higher opportunity or a chance to get a diamond, and a 5-star on an enemy in the multiplayer or in the world war are giving you 100% chance, so a definite diamond for you. The fur is getting produced if you hunt where are they now? A fox, I think, and a rabbit, and even a bear. The bigger the animals are and the more people you or citizens you need to hunt them, the higher the opportunity or the chance to get the trade code from them. And these pigs over here, I don't know how they are called, this pig over here, and the stags, no, stag is this over here, but the female form of this animal is giving you the fur. Over here you can get your gold, and over here at the trees you can just get your cider. And at least you can spend all of these trade goods, and that's why they are so essential and so important for everyone. You can spend them in your mercenary camp to hire some mercenaries, in your temple to gain or to earn some blessings for your base, and at least in your storage buildings to get some crates or shipments in which you can just store some amounts of gold, food or oil without being able or being unattainable for people who are attacking you. So at least I have some recommendations for you. The amount of resources you can have are really depending on your age and your stage of research. So I think you will start with about 4 or 6 maximum trade goods in the classical age, and then in every age you are able to one time upgrade your storage building, which increases your total amount of trade goods by 2, so that you can get at least at a maximum of 14 in the gunpowder age. But there is a huge gap up to the enlightenment age, because in the enlightenment age you can also, like in all every other age, once upgrade your storage building, but you can also, and that's additional in the enlightenment age, research this bank thing over here, this bank chapter. And in this bank chapter there are 3 after the current or last update, which gained the fifth chapter on it. You have 3 chapters which increase the amount of your trade goods every time by 2. So at least in the enlightenment age you can get not to a maximum of 16 but to a maximum of 22 trade goods. That's really, really awesome, because that is an amount which you can really, really easy and really nice work in In former ages, it's a little bit hard because 14 and less amount of trade goods are not very much, especially for the costs of blessing and all of that. So now I can. What recommendations can I give you to have at least a sufficient and a good amount of trade goods? If you have your trade goods completely full, like my fur, for example, then they are getting golden in a gold color. Ah, there's an additional way to get some. Your leak boat and your victory chest over here are able to give you some trade goods, but the boat is only coming every 23, in some cases only 22 hours, depending on a research stage, and gives you a specific amount of random trade goods depending on your leak, on the league bonus you are, depending on the league, how high you are at least of all leagues. But that's not the matter I want to talk with you about, because you can affect it only really hard and you need much time to do it. So what recommendations can I give you? If you have a maximum of your trade goods, it's really nice because you have a lot of savings which you can use in some cases to get mercenaries if you had to use them, if you had to use some blessings. But at least it's also a problem because your trade house, like you can probably see, is in a visual effect really full of trade goods. But also if someone is attacking you, at the right side of the screen there are available trade goods for these people who are attacking you, and these available trade goods depends on how many trade goods you have stored. And if you have stored all trade goods to the maximum, the enemy players are getting really many trade goods by destroying your town center and your storage building. So at least they can steal, I think, in my case, in the industrial age, and I'm only on enlightenment age status. In industrial age, if you have upgraded every storage possibility to the max, you can get stolen by 8, 9 or probably 10 trade goods, and that's a huge amount. Therefore, I can only recommend to you to save a specific amount of trade goods. I, for myself, I'm not saving more than 15 cider, 15 metal, and 6 up to 8 diamonds. That has a following reason, because diamonds are probably, especially for players who are playing for the medal ranking and for league bonuses and something like that, diamonds are the most valuable resource or the most valuable trade good you can have, and everyone tries to sneak and to steal them from you. But you for yourself only need these diamonds to hire some tank or cavalry mercenaries to get the training with 2 diamonds, or the fortress blessing with only 1 diamond, and to get some oil crates or oil shipments right at your oil refinery. But it's always only costing 1 up to 2 diamonds. The most blessings and things like that are costing only 1 up to 2 diamonds. So the amount of diamond is really, really high, and you should not max it out. I would just spend them at least for some oil shipments, which you can use later if you are short on oil, or if you are close to the amount of oil you need for a new upgrade or a new research. You can just open some of these shipments which cannot being stolen from you, from attackers. They are invisible for attackers. And therefore, I would at least store an amount of 6 up to 8 diamonds. More you don't need, because you can get new ones from World War and from the multiplayer. But if you store more of them, the risk of getting stolen is really, really high. Metal and cider you can nearly always gain at your mines and at your trees by just using them when they are ready, all 4 hours. And so you have probably the opportunity to produce an infinite amount of cider and of metal, and therefore I'm always spending them, also like diamonds. The cider I'm using at my markets to get some gold shipments, which have a specific amount between 5,000 and 15,000 in my case of gold, which are just all of the place laying around here and being able to get opened from me. And the metal I'm using to get the same in food shipments, which are also and which also have an amount of 5,000 up to 15,000 food to open. And that's my recommendation. Fur and leather are not that much important, but your diamonds at least are the most important trade good, I think, and the second most important are the cider and the metal. A recommendation or a tip for your mercenary camp: make always sure to have a good mercenary camp with you, so that in a group fight which is getting close or which you are probably losing, you can just use your mercenary camp as reinforcements, which are really helping you to get at least one more star or even the completely fight one. Therefore, always when you have used your mercenary camp, I would fill it up again. And then if you have done it, save at least 6 diamonds and a little bit of fur leather and metal to get these 3 blessings. These 3 blessings are really helpful. Sometimes there are some unexpected, very good multiplayer fights. In my case, for example, when I'm playing and there's sometime one player which I can get 600 or 700,000 gold from it. And I stole 600 or 700,000 gold, and the amount of gold, food or oil is getting that much high that I could not expect it, and I'm quite aware or I'm quite able to upgrade or to research a new thing I wanted to do, but I don't have to enough citizens, for example. There's one category or one aspect which is too little to do the next upgrade, but I have a really high amount of gold, food or oil, and I don't want to get offline with this. But I'm not able to manage this problem, therefore I have to go offline, but I can protect it in a specific way with using these 3 blessings. I think most of you know what these 3 blessings are affecting, but I will sum it up. The fortress blessing, like you can see, all buildings which are highlighted, and that are all buildings I have, are getting strengthened up by 22% by this blessing. This blessing is only working for one attack, so for one defensive, like all the other blessings too. The tower blessings, like you can see, highlights all my defensive buildings, so it strengthens the defensive buildings, or it increases the power of my defensive buildings by 22%. And the storage blessing, you can see only all of my resource buildings are getting highlighted. And the storage blessing is just making that when I'm getting attacked, there's a specific amount of gold, food and oil, even trade goods, which can be stolen from me. And when someone stole these ones from me and the storage blessing is active, I can go to my defensive log and claim a specific reward, which are 27% of the stolen resources, which I can getting refounded. Because of this blessing. Therefore, I'm always making sure to have enough trade goods with me to activate these 3 blessings in a moment when I could not expect how high my resource amount got. For the storage blessing, you need 4 metal and 4 leather, I think. For the tower blessing, you need 3 leather and 3 fur. And for the fortress blessing, I think you need 1 diamond and 2 leather, so at least you should have 5 leather, 1 diamond and 7 fur. I'm not quite sure, and 7 fur to get these 3 blessings. Yes, that was all of my recommendations I could give to you. I will sum it up and put it down in the video description so that everybody of you which is not sure of these facts just can read it in a summary. I will go to the multiplayer again to make this episode a little bit longer and a little bit more entertaining than only talking and scrolling around my base. This guy looks pretty delicious. The most important storage buildings he did not only put them at the outside, like you can probably see. The most important of his storage buildings he put outside and even completely at the edge. The building which stores the trade goods, I don't know the name anymore. He put them just right at the most outer edge. So they are really easy to get destroyed. That was not a really good base layout, I think. Even when he wants to protect, I don't know what he wants to protect. The town center is also not defended. Oh, I completely forgot. I wanted to talk with you about a second topic. I just shortly retrain my troops. And then let us talk about our current event. And the current event is starting in 2 hours. But there is also another event, I'm not quite sure, but it seems to be the same event. The birthday or the anniversary day for the Korean nation and it's already running and it lasts up to Monday morning. And you will get a 50% increase on your training time for your troops, a 75% increase on your tactic training, and 50% off on your barracks, on your mercenary camp, and on your war academy. That's really, really awesome, because looting in the current time is really, really worth it. I'm just always using it. I only need 8 minutes to train a dynamite tactic, which is ordinary, lasting for 35 minutes, and I don't have to use my training blessing, because the troops are getting so fast trained that I can just always just attack. And I don't need the training blessing. If you are using the training blessing, it is stackable. So the bonus of the event and the bonus of your training blessing are just stacking, and additional. They are additional to another. So when you are using your training blessing, the troops are not getting produced twice as fast because of the event. By the event, you have a 50% increase on training time on your troops. So the training time is twice as fast, and if you are activating the training blessing, you will speed the ordinary time of training up by 3, but they are multiplied. So if you are just using the training blessing within the current event, you will have a 6 time increased training time for your troops, and that's just ridiculous. All of my close combat fighters are just trained within 7 seconds. My cannons are just produced in 2 or 3 minutes, and that's really, really worth it. You can look at my base. I nearly upgraded 5 or 6 of these pieces of wall within the last day yesterday, within 3 hours, I think. I nearly got my complete Baron challenge over here. 200,000 more gold, and then I have robbed 1 billion of gold in the multiplayer. Really awesome, guys. Really, really awesome. I will just use this event to upgrade the last few parts of my wall, so that the inner circle or the inner arms of my base are just completely on level 11. I just really like it. We'll go to the multiplayer and do something for it. The event itself, I'm not quite sure what it will bring to us. It's a Korean birthday event, so I think we are able to get the Korean specific nation troops, the Huarang, but in this case I'm not sure what will be the bonus for the Korean nation player itself, for the players which have ordinary just the Korean Huarang ranged infantry marksmen. Therefore I'm really looking forward what the rewards will be in the current event, which will start in 2 hours. Yes. My plans got completely messed up by this event, because I planned to upgrade in 7 hours my third air defense is getting finished. And when the air defense is finished, I planned to spend these people, the citizens which built it, right into upgrading the next air defense. But now I get 50% off from my barracks and from my mercenary camp, and I just have to crash my plans completely. I will just put all of my my workers which I have available in my mercenary camp, and then in my barracks, so that I will get the Flampanzers, which are really, really useful in the World War, especially, and that my troop capacity is ongoing increasing. Because of the library research of the new 5th chapter, I already got plus 5% troop capacity, so I'm at 125 troops now, but I can 3 times upgrade my barracks, and oh, nice. Not quite sure whether the gold is completely in the storage buildings or not. We have to see it. But I'm able to get additional capacity of 3 times by 5. One in total, I can get 140 troops, I think. Yes, an amount of 140 troops. Really awesome. Come on, my little motorcycle riders. No, he's really silly. Nice, but I think I nearly got all of the gold. There is the last bunch of gold. Yes. Now come for the command post. There is the last gold inside. And even some oil. Thanks a lot. And we will retreat. Oh, 18 motorcycle rider. Not that much efficient, this attack. So I think for now we are doing, we'll do our last. There, I got it. Robber Baron or whatever. 1 billion gold in the multiplayer. Pah, that's a huge amount. That cost me 7 months of my life. I'm playing from, from February up to now. I'm just February I first entered this game. And now I got 1 billion gold. Whew, that's crazy. Strange feeling. Okay, come on. Don't be so laggy. Let us do our last multiplayer attack. Here's a really nice command post. I think there are some resources in, but these resources are too good protected that I could get it with my little few amount of troops. Nope. Okay, this enemy seems to be a pretty delicious last enemy for my attack, for my last attack in the video. These range or this space over here seems to be filled with some traps, therefore I will come from another way. Not quite sure, let's see what's here. Some traps? No, no traps. I can just use all of my raiders, because I dropped my medal account below 400 medals, and that's enough. I will retrain another army with which I can get some more medals. Come on, some trade goods, please. Yes, some cider and some fur. That's quite okay. At least let's try to get these this oil over here. Yes. Also some oil. And where's the last gold over here? That looks really well. Okay. Come on, guys. I don't need you anytime anymore. Four of you, I will need four. Okay, now we can go. Good job, guys. Nice loot. So, we are finally at the end of my video. I hope you liked the video, I hope it entertained you and there were some facts you already didn't know which were quite new to you. So let me know your opinion and your feelings about the video just down in the comment section like always before. We'll see you soon. Your domination tips.